Hey guys, today is the 24th of July 2014 and Apple is due to release OS X Yosemite as a public beta. So if you've signed up to be part of this, there are a couple of steps you should take to prepare your Mac before you actually complete the install. So that's what we're going to look at in this video. This video is aimed at beginners. Apologies if it seems obvious, some of the things that I'm stating here. Okay, so the first thing you're going to want to do is to back up your Mac. So the easiest way to do that is to use Apple's built-in backup software, which is Time Machine. If you've already got this set up and running, it's really easy. All you need to do is to click on the Time Machine icon and select Backup Now, and that will start a full backup of your Mac. If you're not already using Time Machine to back up your Mac, it's really easy to set up. You will need an external hard drive of some type. That could either be a portable hard drive, a network connected hard drive such as Apple's Time Capsule. So you will need that connected to your Mac. Once you've done that, simply go in System Preferences, select Time Machine. Now if you've not used Time Machine before, it will be set to off. Okay, so switch that on and then simply click on Select Disk. Okay. And then you'll be shown a list of available hard drives. So like I say, if you're using a portable hard drive connected by USB, or if you're using an Apple Time Capsule, it will show up in this list. Simply select the hard drive you want to use and then click on Use Disk. Once you've done that, it will automatically start backing up your Mac. Because it will be the first backup, it may take a few hours to complete. But then once you've done that, your Mac will be all backed up. Okay, the second thing you're going to want to do is to ensure that you have a separate partition on which to install OS X Yosemite Beta. I wouldn't recommend installing it over your main operating system. It is beta software, so it, although I've found it to be fairly stable, you will run into glitches from time to time. You may find that there's certain applications that won't currently run under the beta version, so I recommend installing it onto either onto a second Mac if you're fortunate enough to own more than one Mac, or if you've just got the one Mac, create a separate hard drive partition and install it onto that. Again, this is really easy to do. Go into Disk Utility, and once that loads, you'll see a list of all of the hard drives that are currently connected to your Mac. Now as you can see, I'm using a Mac Pro, so I've got a number of internal hard drives in my Mac which have all listed there. But generally, if you're using something like a MacBook or an iMac, you will most likely only have one hard drive installed. So that normally shows up at the top here. And it's usually called something like Macintosh HD. Simply select that, go to Partition, and then that will show you the selected Macintosh HD hard drive. As you can see, the one I'm using here is actually pretty full. I need to do a bit of clearing out there. But what you should be able to do is, if you just underneath partition layout, if you click on that option there, And it will give you the option of splitting your hard drive into two or more partitions. In fact, I can show you that on one of the other hard drives I've got installed. Go to this one here. So this is actually how I've got my current beta version of Yosemite installed. It's actually on a separate hard drive, which itself has been partitioned into two. So all you would do if this was like your main hard drive as with one partition, you'd simply click on two partitions and it would create two partitions there. You can also change the size of those partitions as well. Give the new partition a name that will make it easily identifiable. So in this case, I've just called it Macintosh 10.10 Beta. You might want to call it something like Yosemite. Just something that's easy, makes it easy to identify. Because when you go to install the beta version of Yosemite, it will, during the install process, ask you on which partition you want to install the operating system. So you need to be able to identify easily the partition that you've created. So once you've got your two partitions there, you just click on apply. Everything else will be dealt with automatically. Once that's completed, you will have two partitions on your internal hard drive. Okay, so I hope you found this this quick guide useful. If you take these two really quick, easy steps, you should be have your Mac all ready and prepared, so that as soon as you've downloaded the public beta version of Yosemite, you should then have a fairly painless experience installing the software. Okay, thanks for watching this video. Feel free to leave a comment and please subscribe.